Hello guys, welcome to the Tech Tips Zone channel. In this video, we will discuss how to manually install Windows 11 2.3H2 on an unsupported PC. Microsoft's Windows 11 requirements have not changed a bit, and you still need a TPM and secure boot PC with 4GB RAM to run the operating system along with UEFI BIOS. But we can use Rufus to bypass this requirement. First, let me showcase you the version. You can see that I am running Windows 10 version 2.2H2. We will use Rufus to bypass this. Let's check the TPM settings, and you can see that there is no TPM on my PC. However, we will successfully install the Windows 11 version 2.3H2 on this PC by using Rufus to bypass the Windows 11 requirements. This hack is not new, but Rufus has received some updates after which you can prepare the installation media. Just download the latest 4.3 version. Download this P version because it is a portable version and you don't need to install it. You can run it directly. You also need to download the Windows 11 ISO file on your PC, the 2.3H2 ISO file. I will give a link in the description box. Please check that. Now, please open the File Explorer app on your PC, and then we can get going to the next step. You can see that I have this Windows 11 2.3H2 ISO downloaded from the official Microsoft website along with the portable version of this Rufus software. First, let me show you what happens if I try to run an in-place upgrade and install Windows 11 2.3H2 directly. Just run this setup file, run as administrator, and click on the Yes button. The setup will start as it normally does. I'll try to change the download settings and then click on next, and now it will check if my PC is compatible or not. And you guys already know that I don't have any TPM on my PC, and this check will confirm that and stop me from installing Windows 11 2.3H2. But don't worry, as we have Rufus on our side, and it will help us install this on an unsupported PC. Just launch Rufus now and plug in the USB drive on which we will create the USB installation media for Windows 11 2.3H2. Select your device, the USB device from this device section, and then browse for the Windows 11 2.3H2 ISO file. Just click on it and select the 2.3H2 ISO file. After that, you will see a target system option here. If you have UEFI on your system, you can use UEFI, or you can prepare a BIOS version of this Windows installation media as well. I will change the name of the USB drive to help me recognize it in the BIOS. I will name it Windows 11 Unsupported, but you can keep the name as it is. Now, everything is checked, just click on the start button. Now you can see that Rufus offers some customization options. Please keep the first option checked, which says remove requirement for 4GB plus RAM plus secure boot and TPM 2.0. Next, also check the box remove requirement for an online Microsoft account, and click on the disable data collection skip privacy options. This will skip the part in the installation where it asks you to allow some privacy settings like location and diagnostic data. Just click on the OK button, and Rufus will start creating a USB drive. Please use a USB 3.0 drive, or the installation will be much slower than you will expect. Click on the close button and let's check the File Explorer if the USB drive. Yes, you can see that the USB drive has been renamed and now contains Windows installation. Let's restart the PC and boot using the USB drive. Since I am demonstrating this in a virtual machine, my BIOS will appear a bit different than what it will on your device. So you just need to open the boot options and select the bootable USB drive you just created with Rufus. Select the USB device and boot using it. Wait for the Windows setup to launch. It can take some time. And now we are in the Windows setup page. Pick the language, currency, and format and click on the next button. Now click on the install now button. The setup will start. And from here on, earlier you were prompted if you had an unsupported PC, but now since we have modified the ISO, we don't need to do anything and will never face the error message again. Just select a Windows edition and click on the next button. Accept the EULA and click on next. Click on the custom install Windows only button. Pick your primary drive, that is C drive, and you must clean it before installing the next version of Windows. Just click on the format option and click on OK, or you can delete all the drives on your system. Remember that formatting the C drive will remove all your personal info, so make sure you backup that on an external hard disk or USB. After that, continue with the installation process and restart your PC. Your PC can restart multiple times before it boots to the Windows out of box experience page. The OOB page now launched and we need to pick the current region. Just click on yes button after picking it, and then you need to pick the keyboard layout. Click on the yes button and then click on the skip button. It will ask you to name your device. Just click on skip for now. After that, click on the setup for personal use if you're using it as a personal device. We used Rufus and asked it to remove this online requirement, but it appears that it failed to do so. But don't worry, we can still bypass it. Click on the sign in button and now enter a bogus email. Like I'm entering one. Just input this bogus email. You can use this exact one. There's no issue with it. And then click on the next button. Now type a random password. I will also link a video where I have described this process in detail. And then click on the next button again. Now it will ask you to set your Windows 11 PC locally. Just enter your name and then enter a password. Re-enter your password. Now you have to pick three security questions. Pick any three and make sure to remember the answers, because it will help you reset your PC and get access to it if you ever forget your password. You can see that the setup skipped the privacy questions as we configured it to do when we were creating a bootable drive with Rufus. So that one worked, but Windows 11 account system wasn't. Now we have booted to the Windows 11 desktop. Let me showcase you the Windows version. Just type winver command and run it. And you can see that now we have successfully installed Windows 11 2.3.h2 on an unsupported PC. So this is a simple hack to get around the pesky system requirements laid down by Microsoft and install the latest version of Windows 11 on your PC. Make sure to like and share this video with all Windows lovers who want to try out the latest Windows 11 2.3.h2 on their old PCs. Also consider subscribing to this channel, because a lot of you guys just skip on the subscribe option. It will motivate me to make better content in the future.